As you've heard, George Butterworth was killed on the Somme on the 5th of August, 1916. Exactly 1 week later, about 4 miles south, a group of soldiers were returning from the front line for a rest. A shell exploded above them. One man was killed instantly, and two were mortally wounded. One of those mortally wounded was taken to a nearby dressing station and died. He was my great uncle. And I sing a programme that includes some of his letters home to his family in Lancashire and some songs. I'm just going to give you a couple of extracts from those letters this evening, which will go between the Butterworth songs. The Butterworth songs that I will sing are Think No More Lad and Loveliest of Trees. And both are from are written to texts from A. Houseman's A Shropshire Lad. Rifleman J. Ellicott, number 3604, number 2 Platoon, A Company, 5th South Lancs Regiment, British Expeditionary Force, France, care of GPO, London. Dear Mother and Father, I am writing this letter within sound of the guns, and we arrived here after a 3 days train ride after leaving Rouen, as they took us to Belgium in mistake for our base. Talk about a train ride, it was simply awful. The train travelled that fast as we could get out of it and walk alongside it. I think it was going at the rate of 2.5 miles an hour, so you can guess we had plenty of time to view the country, which is simply splendid. The French people are very amusing when they try to explain things to us. I think the only thing they can say in English is, "Are we downhearted and Tipperary?" And the French soldiers puts me in mind of the Keystone Police. Well, Mother, we're expecting to go in the trenches in a few days from now. I hope you'll excuse this short letter, as we're not allowed to say much. So I will close, hoping as it finds you all in the best of health as it leaves me the same. I close with heaps of love from your loving son, Jack. For our Harry, kiss kiss. P.S. Please send me some writing paper and envelopes and a few fags, as they're very scarce here. And don't forget to write soon. Bonsoir.
Trolling, why should men make haste to die? Empty heads and tongues are talking, make the rough road easy walking, and the feather pate of Hallé bears the morning sky. Oh, 'tis jesting, dancing, drinking, spins the heavy world around. Hearts were not so clever, oh, they would be young forever. Think no more, 'tis only thinking lays lads underground. Think no more, lad, laugh be jolly, why should men make haste to die? Empty heads and tongues are talking, make the rough road easy walking, and the feather paint of Hallé bears the morning sky.
Rifleman J. Ellicott, number 3604, same address as usual, August 22nd. 1915. Dear Mother, when we came on our way to the trenches, it made me think, I can tell you. We came through a village and there wasn't an house left standing, and a church wasn't spared either. Talk about ruins, I can hardly describe them. Anyway, I am pleased as I am doing my little bit,
And I think if any of those lads as I seen when I was home on leave could only see the damage what the Germans has caused around here, they wouldn't hesitate in presenting themselves to the nearest recruiting office. That's if they have any pluck at all. I think it would be God help England if they ever got across. But you can take it from me, I don't see them ever getting there. Well, Mother, I hope you'll excuse the paper being dirty, as it's considered to be a luxury getting a wash whilst in the trenches. Anyway, I will have plenty of time when we come out, as we'll be out for 8 days. So I will draw to a close, hoping this letter finds all at home in the best of health, and I conclude with love from your ever-loving son, Jack. Good night. P.S. For Harry, kiss, kiss.
We'll now move on to the Vaughan Williams. As we were told earlier, the poems again are A. Housman, and 1896, A Shropshire Lad was published. So they are prophetic in some ways. They're well before the First World War. But in these you will hear that longing and that very English feel to the poetry. Apparently, Housman never liked using Latin at words. He always liked using Anglo-Saxon ones. There aren't any of those Anglo-Saxon ones. So yeah, and one particular song really that If I could just point out, is my team ploughing, where you will hear a conversation between the ghost of a young man who's died and his friend. I'll let the band tune.
Thank you.